have to say. For someone who teaches ethnic studies and does stuff in women of color, the concept of authenticity, of who gets to speak, who gets to represent a particular culture is really paramount, particularly for women of color who feel that we're not represented. We want to represent ourselves. We want to write our own books. Most as far as I know, you are not black. So, and I've been here for a long time.
I have confessed that many times.
Yeah.
As you may have noticed, I'm black.
Okay. How did you enter this process? What were the things that you were thinking about? Because, we do really similar work. So.
Right. So part of it, as I said, was that I had already read a lot of slave narratives. I had read poetry and sermons and essays, so that wasn't like I was coming to the world. Now, if you asked me to write a book about a white woman who was a farm wife in Kansas in the 1920s, I wouldn't know where to start, because that voice isn't there, or those voices aren't there. When you're a novelist, you have to make everybody in your book compelling. So, you know, one of the best compliments I got in the book was somebody who said, well, I knew you were going to do fine with Mary Bowser, but you did Bette Van Loo pretty well, too. That is to say, Bette Van Loo, this white woman, could either be a saint. She freed us. Wasn't she fantastic? She fought against the Confederacy. Wasn't she fantastic? Or she could be this bad guy, an easy bad guy. And she's much more complicated than that. That to create a character like that, or like her mother, who is happy to own slaves, although by the end of the book, her views towards Mary and towards many things changed. That when you're writing, you have to make every character real in that way, and I think that honoring Mary Bowser's story is about appreciating that. And that realizing that for anybody to come to this story, I don't know anybody, white or black, who's alive today who was experiencing slavery in this country in the 19th century, right? So to believe that that doesn't come from the hard work of going back to, you know, as I said, I read Harriet Newby's letters. She's not the only slave woman whose letters and journals and things I looked at. So I think some of it is also honoring the people who lived that experience and getting as close to what their voices were as possible, and that's an important thing for anybody to do.